Hi guys! Today we are going to install Drupal 8 on Nginx using Php-Fpm on Ubuntu 16.04. The first step is to update our Ubuntu repository. So for that we must first become root user by typing the following command: sudo su. We then have to enter our password, and then we will have to update our repository by using sudo apt-get update. This command might take a while to be fully executed depending on your internet connection. Okay, now that the repository has been updated, we can install Nginx and php-fpm. So for that, we will type sudo apt-get install nginx -y. We enter -y at the end of this command so that Ubuntu doesn't prompt us for confirmation for installing this software after we enter the command. This might take a while. Once that's done, we then install php-fpm along with php-gd and other extensions that are required by Drupal 8 core. For that, we will run this command: sudo apt-get install php7.0-fpm, php7.0-gd, php7.0-mysql, php7.0-xml, and -y at the end of this command. This might also take a while. Now that we have installed Nginx and php-fpm, we can move on to step 3. In this step, we will configure Nginx to use php-fpm to serve HTTP requests to PHP pages. So we will go to the php-fpm directory by typing cd space slash etc slash php slash 7.0 slash fpm. Once that's done, we will then open the php dot ini file by typing get space php dot ini. This will open up the file in the inbuilt editor of Ubuntu, but you can use your favorite text editor such as Kate or Sublime Text. Nothing will change. Okay, once that's done, we have to go to line 761. We have to remove the semicolon in front of the line so that we can uncomment it, and we also have to change the value of cdi.fix_pathinfo from 1 to 0. And once that's done, we can now save and quit the file. And now we have to modify the default Nginx virtual host configuration by editing the default file and enabling the php-fpm directive. So for that, we will type cd space etc slash nginx slash sites dash available, and then we will type get space default to open up the file. And in this file, we are going to have to uncomment the line 51, 52, 57, and 58. For that, we will remove the hash which is in front of the line to uncomment them. When we have done that, we will then save and close the file. Okay, now we have to test the Nginx configuration. For that, we will use Nginx space -t. Since there are no errors, we will restart the Nginx and the php-fpm services by typing systemctl space restart space nginx, and we will also enter systemctl space restart space php7.0-fpm. Next, we have to test that php-fpm is working with Nginx by creating a new php info file. For that, we first have to enter cd space slash var slash www slash html. Once we have done that, we will then type echo open quote, open PHP tag, space PHP info, open and close brackets, semicolon, close PHP tag, close quote, and left arrow, space info.php. Once we have done that, we will then enter ifconfig and highlight the first address, IP address as I've shown you, and we will copy that IP address, and we will go to our web browser, and we will then enter that IP address there, it's the server IP, and we will enter slash info.php. Now, this should redirect us through the info page of PHP, if our Nginx has been created correctly, and you will should see a page similar to mine on your screen. If you have done this, then the configuration has been successful and we can move on to the next step. In step 4, we will install and configure MariaDB. So first, let's install MariaDB with the apt-get command. For that, we will type sudo apt-get install mariadb-client mariadb-server -y. So this process can take a while depending on the speed of your internet connection. And when that's done, we will then enter systemctl start mysql to start the service for MariaDB. And once that's done, we will configure MariaDB with mysql underscore secure underscore connection. So it will prompt us for a few confirmations. So first we have to enter our password if you have a root password. If you don't have one, then you just press enter. And since I have a root password, I'll be entering no. But if you don't have one, then probably you should press yes. And the rest of the prompts, you should enter y, because that's the most secure one. Once that's done, we will then log into the MariaDB shell with our password, and we'll be creating a new database named for Drupal. So let's start it with mysql minus u root minus p. We will have to enter our password, and once that's done, we will then enter create database Drupal. And this will create a database named Drupal. Then we'll be creating a new user named Drupal user. So for that, we will enter create user Drupal user at localhost identified by code Drupal user at code semicolon. Next, we'll be granting all privileges for this user for the Drupal database. So we'll use grant all privileges on Drupal to Drupal user at localhost identified by Drupal user at semicolon. Next, we'll be refreshing the privileges with flush privileges. And then finally, we will quit by entering backslash q. In step 5, we will generate a self-signed SSL certificate. For that, we will go to etc/nginx and create a directory named SSL for this SSL configuration file. First, we will make the directory by entering mkdir-p space etc/nginx/ssl, and then we will go to that enter that directory by entering cd space /etc/nginx/ssl, and then we will enter this command to generate a new self-signed SSL certificate. So the command is open SSL req minus x509 minus nodes and so on. And we will also have to enter our details. So first we'll enter the country name, which is a two-letter code. I'm using MU for Mauritius. Then we will have to enter our state, and then we will enter the locality name, which is for me Manil. And after that, enter the organization name. So this is for Google Codein, so I'm entering Google Codein, and I'm a student, so I'm putting that in there. But there are many of these fields that you can leave blank by entering a dot, a point, and I'm going to enter in dummy email address. So once we have filled in the requested info, we will now change the permissions of the key to 600 by typing chmod space 600 space drupal.key. And that's it for this step, and we can now move on to step 6. In step 6, we will configure the virtual host for Drupal. First, we will install Drupal in /www/drupal8 with the domain name drupal8. So for that, we will first make a directory with the mkdir command in /www named drupal8. And then we'll go to the Nginx virtual host directory by typing cd /etc/nginx/sites-available. And then we'll open up a new file with gedit space drupal8. Let's just change that and put gedit. Okay, so in here we will paste this Nginx configuration for Drupal inside the file, and don't worry about this part. This will be available in the description in a text file, and the other commands and instructions will also be there. So let's just copy this and paste it in there. And at the beginning of this file, there is a line for server name. And there we have typed Drupal 8, but if you want to change your server name, you just have to change that line. So let me go up, and there it is. So I have entered Drupal 8, as you can see, but you can change it and enter another server name if you want, but then you will also have to change it in the etc/hosts file. So once that's done, let's create a system link in the to the file in the sites enabled directory in order to activate the Drupal virtual host. So for that, type this command, the ln command, and after that, let's just test the Nginx configuration to ensure that everything's working properly with Nginx -t, enter, and the test is successful. So let's just restart the Nginx service with systemctl. Okay, that's it for this step. Let's move on to step 7. Our last step is to install and configure Drupal. First, we will install Git and Rush before we install Drupal. Please note that this step is not really required, but it is highly recommended because you will use Git later on for Drupal development and to contribute to the Drupal community, and Rush can really come in handy when using Drupal. So first, we are going to install them using the apt-get command. So we'll enter sudo apt-get install git drush minus y, and I'm having an error. I missed install, so it should be sudo apt-get install instead of sudo apt-get. Let's enter that and try again, and I'm still having an error. So I think there's a problem with my drush. I think the package name could have changed, but I can't find any info online. So I'm going to skip past that, but if you're interested to download Rush, then you can find a link in the description to use pair, the pair method, to install Rush. But I'm going to be skipping through that as I don't need it in this tutorial. So next, we will go to /www/drupal8, and there we will download our Drupal. So I'm going to be downloading the current version, but you may need to check again. By the time you're watching this, there could be a new version. So we're going to be using either wget command, or you could use drush to download Drupal 8. I'm going to be using wget, and this could take a while. And after that, we are going to have to extract the file, which is a tar.gz file right now, and it will put it in a folder. And we're going to rename it, and once we have renamed it, we will use the rm command to remove the remains. Next, we will configure the Drupal setting files. So for that, we will go to sites/default by using the cd command. Then we will copy the two configuration files by typing cp space default.settings.php and space settings.php, and we will also use another cp command for settings file. And next, let's make a new directory named files inside site slash defaults and the ch command, and shows that the configuration file and the files directory are writable for Drupal installations. So we're going to be using mkdir and chmod a plus w star. Okay, so we have one small change to do, and that is to go to gedit etc slash host, which will open up the host file, and should be able to see it. Here it is. And oh, there's a mistake, sorry. And cancel, close this file. It should have missed a slash in the front. Okay, so it should open it up, and as you can see, I have added a line here, and you have to like this line as well, so that we can access Drupal 8 from Nginx, so that we can access this line. And this will depend on what you enter in the configuration file for Drupal 8. And once that's done, we can now save it and close it, and we can now open it up in our browser. Okay, so let's open up our browser, and we will go to Drupal 8 backslash, and we will press enter, and here we are. So I'm going to be choosing English, as that's my preferred language, and choose standard, save and continue, and enter the database name. So we use database name Drupal, and the username was Drupal user, and the password was Drupal user. I didn't enter the password well, so we're going to have to re-enter it. I made a mistake, I forgot to add at the end, so it's Drupal user at, and save. We will have to press save and continue. Okay, so it's going to install Drupal, and this can take a while. Okay, so it's nearly done. Okay, let's enter our site information. So site name masky. So email address, I'm going to enter dummy email, but you should enter one that is real. And username, enter your password and confirm password. I'm leaving the email address as dummy email, and the country, my country is Mauritius, so I'm going to be using Mauritius, and time zone is already set, so press save and continue. And slowly, my internet's quite slow right now. Okay, so it has been installed, and we can see an error message. So for that, we are to do a small step, which is to go to files. So we're going to have to make a directory named files, and then we are going to have to use the chmod command. And we should be good to go, and the error message should disappear. So let's see. So here we go. Okay, so let's reload the page. And here we go, the error message has gone. And so now you have successfully installed Drupal, and as you can see, everything has been working properly. So congratulations, and be sure to check out the description, so because there are important links and all the instructions are there. And yeah, thanks for watching. Bye.